Good morning, students. Can you tell that I love my plants? I love small plants and medium plants and big plants. I love edible plants and I love flowers. There are so many kinds of flowers. From the teeniest sprout to the biggest tree in the world. I wonder, how do plants know how to grow? And how big do they get? Let's investigate. Oh.
Attention.
Hello, sir.
I heard you were interested in learning more about really big trees.
Who are you?
General Sequoia, at your service. I'm calling to tell you that I am 275 feet tall and 36 feet wide at my base.
Whoa, 275 feet tall and 36 feet wide? What are you?
A giant sequoia tree, the biggest tree on Earth. I've been growing on this spot for over 2,000 years.
Wow, and I thought I was getting old. You must have seen a lot in your time. But a tree that big? Whew. I wonder, you've got to be taller than this school building and wider than the street outside. Could that be right? I gotta figure this out. I'll call you right back. Each floor of my school is 14 feet tall. Let's count the floors. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. There are 5 floors. So how tall is the whole building? Well, there are a few ways to do that, right? We can add 14 plus 14 plus 14 plus 14 plus 14, or we can multiply 14 by 5. Let's start by adding the floors together. 14 plus 14. 4 plus 4 is 8, and 1 plus 1 is 2. 28. That's 2 floors. Let's add another 14. 28 plus 14. 8 plus 4 is 12. Carry the 1. 1 plus 2 is 3. Plus 1 is 4. 42. That's 3 floors now. 2 more to go. 42 plus 14. 2 plus 4 is 6. And 4 plus 1 is 5. 56. One more floor now. 56 plus 14. 6 plus 4 is 10. Carry the 1. 1 plus 5 is 6. Plus 1 is 7. 70. That means the whole building is 70 feet tall. Now, there's another way to do this, right? Multiplication. We have 5 floors that are all 14 feet tall. 5 groups of 14. Let's multiply. 14 times 5. 14 is a big number, right? To make it easier, let's break this down and make it into 10 times 5 and 4 times 5. And then add our answers together. 10 times 5. Count by tens 5 times. 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Now, let's do 4 times 5. Let's count by 5s 4 times. 5, 10, 15, 20. So we have 50 and 20. What do we get when we add those numbers together? 50 plus 20 is 70. The same result. My school is 70 feet tall. Now, how tall did General Sequoia say he is? General Sequoia said he is 275 feet tall. How many more schools do we need to get to 275? One school is 70 feet. Two schools, 70 plus 70 is 140. Three schools, 140 plus 70 is 210. 4 schools, 210 plus 70 is 280. Wow, General Sequoia is so tall, you would have to stack 3 more schools on top of mine to reach the same height. OMG, this guy is huge. Can you imagine a tree that big? Now that is a big tree. Tall means how far up something goes. But what about wide? How wide did General Sequoia say he was? That's right, 36 feet wide. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. This street is 36 feet wide. Wow, that's the same width as the general. Hey there, general.
Back straight, shoulders back there, private.
General Sequoia, sir, I just went outside to measure how big this building is and to see how wide the road is. If you are as big as you really say you are, I've definitely never seen anything as big as you. I wonder, can all trees grow that tall?
Definitely not. There are trillions of trees on Earth, but only sequoias, which live in California, grow this tall.
Wow, I have so many more questions. How do you get that big? What are you made of? Do your leaves drop in the fall? Are there any animals that live in your branches?
Whoa. Hold on there, Mr. Ritz. Why don't you just come see for yourself?
That's a great idea. I'll see you soon, General. Would you like to come explore the forest with me? Maybe we can learn a thing or two about the environment that helped General Sequoia get so big. I'll grab my other hat. Let's go! Whoa, where are we? What was that? Oh, I think my magic hat made us a bit smaller this time. This is the forest floor. Wow, I never knew the forest floor was so alive. Look at these fallen leaves. Deciduous trees drop their leaves during autumn when it gets cold. Have you seen trees lose their leaves? I wonder what happens to all those leaves and what are those bugs doing? Leaves fall to the ground and a community of insects and other arthropods, mushrooms, and bacteria eat them and turn them into fresh, nutritious soil that helps trees and plants grow. Thanks, guys. That's an excellent recycling program. What else do you see? I observe seeds on the forest floor. Seeds grow into new plants. Did you know that for every human on Earth, there are 422 trees? All those trees produce a lot of oxygen. My friend Leslie Ladybug taught us that plants make oxygen, and all animals need oxygen to breathe. So let's say thanks to the trees and give them all a big hug. Wow, these trees do so much. They produce leaves, seeds, and oxygen. Trees are excellent producers. One of my favorite things about trees is that trees live in communities called forests. Did you know that there are communities that live in trees? What can you think of that lives in trees? Birds, squirrels, monkeys, and even other plants. Let's take a look. Up, up, up in the tree. Whoa, this is pretty high up. But you know, I feel pretty safe up here. This tree is quite strong, very sturdy.
Hello, who's there?
Oh, Sam the squirrel. Hi there. I didn't mean to disturb you.
Are you after my acorns, Mr. Ritz?
Oh, no. My friends and I were just exploring how strong trees are.
Oh, okay. Well, this one is really strong. That's why you built my nest up here.
I wonder, how do trees get so strong? What are they made of?
Oh, Mr. Ritz, I know this one. Wood. Trees are made of wood.
Well, Sam, wood is made from trees, but trees are made from something else. Trees absorb water through their roots in the ground, and they can absorb carbon dioxide through their leaves. Carbon dioxide is a type of gas in the air. Trees take in water and carbon dioxide and put them together to create building blocks to grow bigger, and they always have some leftover oxygen.
That's incredible! I didn't know trees are made from water and air.
That's right. All plants are.
Huh. You learn something new every day. Hey, did you know that there are more than 200,000 species of edible plants on Earth?
200,000? Wow! I've read that we only eat about 30 of them. I would like to investigate that a little bit more. Maybe we'll visit a farm sometime soon.
Hey, Mr. Ritz, I have a little present just for you.
For me, Sam? Is this?
Inside every seed is a baby plant, and given all the right conditions, can grow into a big, healthy plant. This seed can grow into a new, giant sequoia tree.
It's so small.
Take it home and plant it. Give it water and light. Before long, it won't be small anymore. Nurture it and give it time. Maybe it will grow as big as this tree.
Thank you, Sam. I should get this back to my classroom.
Thanks for coming, Mr. Ritz.
See you soon, Sam. Are you ready? Let's go! Did you know that you can visit the American Museum of Natural History online at www.amnh.org/explore? Take a virtual tour with Google Street View. Test your knowledge of the natural world on Kahoot or explore Ology, the museum's science website for kids. Welcome back to class, students. I had so much fun exploring the forest with you today. Let's draw our friend, the sequoia tree. For this directed drawing, you will simply need a piece of paper and something to draw with, a pencil, crayon, or marker. You might like to use pencil so you can erase, but I'm going to use a marker so you can see it better. The first thing we will do is draw the ground, because trees come up out of the ground. So we will make a simple line. And that line is the ground. The next thing we'll do is we'll draw a line up, up, up. And wow, there is the trunk of the big sequoia tree. We'll put a few lines in for texture. And now we'll start working at the top. We'll work our way around and start right here and make some clumps of leaves. They're like little clouds. We'll do one this way, then we'll do one this way, then we'll keep adding and making lots of leaves around the outside. Look at the layers. We'll make another layer here, and then another layer here. We'll add in some bushy leaves here. We'll make a big set of leaves that go all around the top. And wow, look at that. We have a big leafy tree. Now, if you have some crayons, we can color in and make it brown for the trunk of the tree, but we also learned that sequoias have some red in the wood, so we could add in a little bit of a light brown or red to add all kinds of color, because we know that sequoias are redwood trees. Look at that. Now, on top, we'll start making the bottom a darker green all the way around the bottom and go around here, around the edges. Oh, look at that. You can take your time and color it very carefully. And then, of course, we'll go up to the top and start filling it all in. It's really starting to take on a life of its own. And then we could put some light green in the middle because not all the leaves are the same color. And look at that. We've got some light green, some dark green, a lot of light green where the sun is hitting the tree. That is one big, beautiful sequoia tree. I'll let you finish at home, but you can see how easy it is. And if you want to add in some extra leaves here, and another section here, and maybe one more there, your tree can just keep growing and growing. And we'll just darken it where it needs to be darker and add in all different kinds of color. And look, we have a beautiful sequoia tree. Oh my, we learned so much about trees today. We met General Sequoia and learned that there are more than 200,000 species of edible plants on Earth. We learn that we only eat 30 types of plants. We learn that trees produce leaves, seeds, and oxygen. And we learn that all plants are made of carbon dioxide and water. We learn that it's important to protect forests. We owe trees a big thanks, so get outside and give a tree a big hug. I'll see you next time.